Look at that. That is pretty slick.
Welcome back to the Reflactor channel. I'm about to show you an upgrade that really enhances the usefulness of a standard Crayford focuser. If you've seen my other videos, then you know the drill. You turn this big wheel, which turns a little axle, which is rubbing against the focuser tube, and that makes it go out or in. Now, there's really only one downside to that, and that is you have a 1-to-1 spin ratio between this wheel and that axle. But wouldn't it be really cool if you could, say, gear it down, say a 10-to-1 gear ratio, so that maybe one of the wheels made large coarse movements in the focus, and another wheel made much smaller, fine control movements in the focus? Well, that technology already exists. It's called a dual-speed Crayford focuser. My 12-inch Dobsonian already comes with one. Let me demonstrate that to you.
So here's the Crayford focuser that's on my 12-inch Dobsonian telescope. You can see it has these big silver wheels that have essentially a 1-to-1 ratio for large coarse movements. And then it has this little black wheel right here for fine focus adjustment. Pretty darn cool.
Well, that's all very well and good, except that those dual-speed Crayford focusers are kind of expensive. They start at $200 and they go up to $300 or even beyond. That's where this bit of upgrade technology comes in. Take a good look at that. It's got this big wheel for coarse movements and this little small wheel for fine movements. This is made by a company called Lacerta. There you go. They got that little lizard as their symbol there. It's distributed by a British company called 365astronomy.com. They charge £75 for this, which works out to about $96 US plus whatever the shipping and handling is from the UK. Unfortunately, the reflector budget is pretty tight these days, so what I did was I put this off for a while, and then I found a used one on cloudy nights, and I got this for only $45. That's actually a pretty good deal. Just to reiterate, I bought this with my own money, so this is not a paid endorsement. Now, what's interesting is the Lacerta symbol is a lizard. There it is, right? The Latin word for lizard is Lacerta. That's where the company name comes from. As it turns out, these are so easy to install that you don't even need the instructions. Let's go ahead and put it on the Crayford focuser. So here's one of the standard Crayford focusers that I'm talking about. This one came from an Orion Dobsonian. I believe these are made by a company called Senta. They're sometimes called a Skywatcher Crayford. But I do need to mention that Lacerta actually makes a couple different versions of this. This one is made specifically for this particular Crayford focuser. So make sure you do a little bit of research and make sure you buy the right model. This one has holes that are roughly 1.2 inches apart that way, 0.85 inches that way. Just make sure you get the right model. So the first thing you need to do is remove this back panel. It's just 4 Phillips head screws. We're gonna need this focus lock, so let's pull this out and take the 4 screws out. Remove this back panel. Now, before you attach this, there is a tensioner set screw right in the middle. You want to back that off so that you're not jamming the axle into the focuser tube while you're tightening these screws down. This just takes an Allen wrench, and you back it off quite a ways. That should be good. All right, let's go ahead and attach this. You just set it right there. Now put the 4 screws in. I should mention that it's about 100 degrees here in the workshop. All right, now the tube is still pretty loose, so we're going to tighten this tensioner until we get just the right amount of tension. Just go in little increments. Now let's give it a try. Turn the big knob. Okay, I'm used to this. This is normal. I think this might be 1-to-1. Yeah, that's 1-to-1. But let's try the fine knob now. Look at that. It gives you that very fine control. That is pretty slick. Now, this may look a little bit weird because you got this knob over here, you got the little knob there, but then you got the shaft sticking out here. Well, this is where they got super clever about this. This shaft is the same diameter as the standard shaft that's on here, and this is held on with the set screw. So let's find the right Allen wrench and remove that. All right.
And we'll put that on here. I'll just tighten that set screw down. And there you go. Now, admittedly, it looks a little bit Frankenstein-y, but it works really well. So here you have what you're used to. You have the course adjustment over here. And over here, you still have course adjustment, but you have this fine control knob. Look at that. Pretty darn slick. Now, we can't forget, you got to put in the focus lock. You never know when you're going to need that. If you have a really heavy camera, then you might need to lock it in so that it doesn't slide in under the weight of the camera. I leave it a little bit loose. And there you go.
If you're enjoying this video, please push that like button. After recording this video, I found out that there is a company here in North America that sells this upgrade. It's called David Astro. Now, it's a Canadian company and they charge $115 US for it, plus whatever the shipping cost is. Now, I put this on my spare Crayford focuser that I use in all of my videos, but the real purpose for this is to go on my 8-inch Dobsonian, which I still use a lot. So I'm gonna go ahead and install it on that and show you the finished product.
And here it is installed on my 8-inch Dobsonian for coarse control and fine control. Look at that.
Once you start using a dual speed focuser, it's actually kind of hard to go back. And thanks to the Lacerta upgrade, you can have your cake and eat it too without breaking the bank. If you'd like to see a history of the Crayford focuser and why it's not invented by someone named Mr. Crayford, check out this short documentary that I did right there. Thanks for watching and clear skies, everybody.